And with us now, Dr. Ahmad Shalan, Register of Vascular Surgery in York, UK. Hello, doctor. How are you?
Hi, good afternoon.
Good afternoon. How do you see this Congress from your point of view?
It's very interesting. It's nice to see a big Congress like this in Egypt, and it's very well prepared, and all the topics, I think, is well prepared. And I see guests from everywhere, which makes it a lot rich, and the value of it, I think, is getting better year after year.
Okay, and to what extent do you think that this Congress would promote the awareness and level of service delivered to the patients in Africa and the Middle East?
I think the Congress won't affect the patient in a direct way, but I think increasing the knowledge among the doctors and treating physician in Egypt and Middle East will influence the patient. I can't see any direct subject of this Congress towards the patients, which is something I think the people looking after this meeting should think about it and maybe try to do some forum alongside this meeting to address these issues with patients. I know there's a foundation which has already started last year, but maybe there's something happening, but I'm not aware of it, which is again part of the committee for this meeting to make everyone coming to this to know about what's happening and maybe offer things to do with it, which is again, I think, is more important maybe than only targeting the doctors. It's important to speak to the patient as well as the doctors, yes.
Okay, yeah. What will you present in IMAC conference this year?
I'm presenting one presentation. It's a debate about the open surgery in complex aortic occlusive disease. And it's interesting because the recent guidelines is changing. The last guidelines over the last 5 years always recommend endovascular, which is more related to wires and balloons and stents, minimal invasive surgery. But in the fact, the outcomes of these interventions are not very reliable. There's a lot of re-intervention. And the open surgery, which is looks a bit more invasive, gives the patient bigger wounds with a more risk of infection and maybe post-operative mortality, is still a high risk option, but it still gives a better outcome. And I find it's very interesting because most of these meetings now is sponsored by companies who are more interested in stents and wires, balloons and endovascular companies. And to come in this meeting and start to speak about something different, I think it's important and people need to listen to a different voice, not only saying the same thing and not only supporting the mainstream idea.
Okay, thanks a lot, Dr. Ian. Right, nice to meet you today.